College is about living and learning. From academics to friends, Greek life to campus ministries, experiencing life to the fullest. Chronicling the times of Northwestern State University, this is Demon Life.
Welcome to Demon Life. I'm your host, Nicolay Rimsey. Today's topic is SAB. I'm here joined by the Director of Student Activities Board, Yana.
Hi.
Hey, Yana. What is one word that would describe SAB and why?
Well, the Student Activities Board, to me, in one word to sum everything up, is fun. And the reason why it's fun for me and for our students at Northwestern State is we do a lot of programming on campus that is to help with the extracurricular activities on campus for students. And what is more fun than spending other people's money, if you will, for programming and have the capability of providing programming that students want. So the fun stuff, the bands and the giveaways and the game shows and the haunted house that's coming up. So there's a lot of things that they do that's just fun, and to me that's what SAB stands for.
Okay, before I ask this question, I want to ask you, how do you stay engaged and passionate with your work and responsibilities?
Well, I think that when you wake up in the morning, you have a choice to stay passionate or to not. Yeah. And I love what I do. To me, it's not a job. To me, it's a career. To me, it's my second home. Yeah. I've been at Northwestern since 1996 as a student myself. So I kind of know this institution and I know the wonderful faculty and staff and, of course, the fabulous students that are here. So it's really kind of just second nature to come and love what I do and stay passionate about it and know that every day that I come into work, I do make a difference, whether in one student's life or more.
How can you get some students to come out and join SAB?
Well, I think that one of the good things for the Student Activities Board is that they do have a reputation on campus about having fun and knowing that they can get a lot of meet new people and create some skill sets that are going to be important for them. So it's really not that difficult to get someone out to SAB or to join SAB. We definitely want to, and we have a challenge, and I challenge the students every day to make sure that they try to get their word out about the events that we have.
Yeah.
And it's tough. It's difficult because a lot of our students are definitely stretched very thin. So to get them encouraged to go to an SAB event, much less to join SAB, can be a little bit difficult. But we just did elections for the board just recently.
And how many were elected? I'm sorry to cut you off.
No, it's fine. We had 14 students that were elected for the positions of representatives at large, and that's pretty good. And we had about 17 or 18 that applied. We had more that actually were interested but didn't apply. But again, it's getting them to know what SAB is about, and they have many opportunities to still get involved and still not be a voting member of the board, but still be able to give their ideas to the committees, because we do have open committees that students can get involved in.
Okay, the open committees, what do they do? Do they just help around whenever you need just help?
Well, what happens with the open committees, which are the Lady of the Bracelet, Lanyap, Freshman Factor, Up Till Dawn, and then Freshman Factor, I have to think about it. There's a fifth one, I think, and I can't think of it off the top of my head. I usually keep them in alphabetical order, and I kind of think I skipped one. But we have five open committees, and they have certain tasks at hand that they are in charge of. But students that are not voting members of the board can go to these committee meetings because they're just open. So they can give their ideas, and then they can bring those ideas back to the main board meetings at 4 o'clock on Mondays. Mm-hmm. So, like, for example, Lanyap is in charge of doing, we did the Demon Cash Cart the first week of school. So she was in charge of coordinating that event and getting students, you know, to their classes by using golf carts and giving out prizes. So Lanyap does that event. Then we have Freshman Factor that hosts a multitude of events for, they did the Demon Scavenger Hunt. So they did that, again, giving away prizes as well. Lady of the Bracelet, which tonight, incidentally, we're actually on Tuesday, we are having the Lady of the Bracelet preliminaries, which is we have 18 lovely contestants, but we have to narrow that down. So that committee is in charge of making sure that we have a talent preliminary, we have judges, and we have people there to actually go through that process. So we have just a lot of things that each committee has their own tasks that they have to accomplish.
Yeah.
But any student of Northwestern Northwestern State can go to a committee meeting, okay. give their ideas, give their thoughts, and then we take that and bring it to the board for voting.
Okay. Mm-hmm. When is your next event that's coming up?
Well, the next event is going to be actually starting on Monday. Which is homecoming week.
Oh, okay.
Yes, and we're very excited about it. This year is Demon Heroes, the Legends of Northwestern.
Oh.
And Victoria Hippler is the student representative that has planned homecoming week for our campus. And of course, with the help of the board and other student thoughts and concerns. And so we're planning, the first thing that's happening on Monday is we're having a kickoff party in front of the student union lobby, or in front of the student union. And it's gonna be free food for all students, novelties, which is something in our world, a programming world, or giveaways is what they're called. And we're doing things like design your own skin cover to your cell phone, and a few other like keychain, I think, ideas. And I think we're getting these cool sunglasses and sunshades that you can decorate yourself, like with paint and stuff. So they're going to give free things that are free like that away, as well as entertainment. We're going to have some music out there because, you know, music always sets a mood for any event. And then on Tuesday, we're actually having Are You Smarter Than a Freshman?
Okay, that one.
Yes.
What kind of like giveaways do y'all have for that this year?
We only have one giveaway
because
it is a competition and it's pretty much the last man or girl standing at the event. And what happens when it comes to that is that it's pretty much like the game show, Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader?
Mm-hmm.
And there's questions about trivia about Northwestern and that kind of thing. And the last person standing will win a 32-inch flat screen TV that the Student Activities Board purchased.
Is that like one of y'all most successful events? So like what's one event would be like y'all most successful event of SAB, like your entire career.
Well, I'm gonna have to split up into two different semesters.
Okay.
For the fall semester, I would have to say lip sync. Lip sync is deals with homecoming, and it is the Thursday of homecoming week, which is next Thursday, and that is probably the most attended fall event.
Wow.
Not just because students are in the audience watching lip sync, but we have more participation on the behind the scenes as well.
Mm-hmm.
We have tons of organizations that get involved and want to perform for these students. So you have the student involvement, getting them involved, and then you have, and participate. And then you have those students that are there just to watch their friends make a fool of themselves on stage and have fun with it. But then it's also it's on that Thursday, so some alumni have that opportunity to actually, you know, to come in and watch it as well, because it's open to alumni as well. So that's probably the largest event. And this year, we're actually having Ronnie Jordan, a comedian, come in to MC the event. So instead of us students doing it, it's going to have like, you know, it's going to be entertaining as well as a student event. So that would be for the fall. Now for the spring, I would have to say, I'm a toss up because I am the director of the Lady of the Bracelet pageant. And to me, the pageant is very much an important aspect of Northwestern tradition. And that to me is one of the largest highlights that the Student Activities Board does put on and do host. I mean, we have the Miss Louisiana young lady will come and MC the event. So having that, having her come and speak at our event is pretty a big deal, in my opinion. Besides that, if you're not a pageant kind of person, our biggest event in the spring is obviously our Spring Fling event, which hundreds of students come out for, you know,
so
free crawfish
fun.
And fun and inflatables and music and whatever it may be, whatever that theme is going to be this year. We don't know. It'll come out soon. But that would probably be our spring event.
That is awesome.
Yeah, it's a great event. It's fun.
That is awesome. I had another question too. With the Lady of the Bracelet, what is the prizes for the contestants if, you know, first runner up, third runner up, like if they win?
Well, it is a scholarship program, we are on the Miss America track. So they do have to perform a talent. They have an interview. They do an onstage question. They have an evening gown, that kind of stuff. But pretty much the prizes are going to be full ride scholarship for the winner. And then it goes down to like $1,000 for the first runner-up, and then it breaks down into scholarships for the top five. So top five get scholarship money just for participating in the event. So it's good.
We're going to take a short break, but we will be right back. You're watching Demon Life.
Hi, I rehearsed trying to convey the right emotion. So please don't cause a commotion and mess me up.
I spend countless hours moving with grace, so please be careful with flashing cameras. They can be distracting.
I spend countless hours trying to perfect my pitch. So please silence your cell phones. I want to be heard.
Please adhere to the rules so we can put on our best performance for you.
Looking for a way to stay healthy and get into shape? Then come and join NSU's Wellness Recreation and Activity Center. The rack contains two large gyms for basketball, volleyball, and badminton, racquetball courts, free weight room, strength and cardio rooms, group exercise room, and an indoor track. The rack has a fully staffed service center and will serve all of your health needs. Come and start your lifestyle change today at the NSU rack.
KNWD is back and better than ever, with more shows and more music that you can't find anywhere else on the dial. So if you're ready for a break from the other guys, tune into 91.7 FM, The Demon. And we're always looking for energetic voices, so stop by Room 109 Kaiser and pick up an application and get ready to rock. KNWD 91.7, The Demon.
It could have been half a century ago.
Or maybe it was just last spring.
It doesn't matter how long ago you graduated, because here, you're still family.
No matter where your education has taken you, or how much you think things have changed,
Northwestern is still home.
Chronicling the times of Northwestern State University, this is Demon Life.
Welcome back to Demon Life. I'm your host, Nicolay Wren, and today's topic is SAV. I'm joined by Yana, the Director of Student Activities.
Hello, hello.
Hey, Yana. So with the Lady the Bracelet, after, you know, they get crowned and stuff, what do they have to do, like, afterwards? Like,
they have, well, for one, they're the representative of Northwestern State and across the state, and promoting the Children's Miracle Network, but also preparing for the Miss Louisiana pageant. Yeah. That happens in June. So we have to get all the paperwork. She has to get all of her wardrobe together, and she has to practice her talent from January this year to June. She has to get ready. But March, we have a meeting with the Miss Louisiana organization in Monroe, because the pageant is always hosted in the Monroe area. Yeah. So we have to get her prepared and ready to go. And not to mention, she's a student, so she also has to maintain her grades because it is a scholarship program and she could lose her scholarship. So
okay, with that one, sorry to interrupt you again.
No,
I want to know, do like she has to be here at this Northwestern, or could she be like the one in Shreveport, or like, how does that work out?
As long as that she is a full-time Northwestern State University student, mm-hmm. she can join, or she can try out or compete in the Miss Lady the Bracelet pageant.
Yeah.
Because you pay a fee, it's perfectly fine. So a student can be an internet student and make sure that they come in and do all the requirements that any other student can do. Mm-hmm. They have the opportunity to wear the crown and the bracelet as well.
Oh, okay. Well, up to dawn, like, what do y'all, like, do and up to dawn? Do y'all, like, just, I don't know, like
what we are? Well, Up Till Dawn is an organization that promotes the awareness and fundraising efforts for mm-hmm. St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. And in September, late September, we had our Awareness Week, where we did events all throughout the week to raise awareness of for St. Jude and yeah, what we do on
our
campus.
Successful.
It was a great week. We raised almost $800 for that week. And our goal isn't just to raise money. It's also to raise awareness of what St. Jude can do and what they do for those families that mm-hmm. are affected by childhood cancer.
Yeah.
And right now we're in the process of every Tuesday at 4:00, we have open meetings, which is our open committee.